So what did we have a lot of, we get a lot of interest. In fact, Cody's going to be doing a webinar about transitioning to telesales.
Mm-hmm.
What would, before I get in there, I'm not saying, nobody's saying the field sales is wrong or dead or it's a subpar, but for those of individuals that are looking to get into telesales from field sales, what would you recommend? What are some steps that you would recommend them take, or just some wisdom you could kind of shed on those?
I think what you need to do first is look back at your field sales experience and reflect on what you would have done different in that aspect first.
Okay.
I think a lot of people go into building something and don't count the cost before they do it. So you got to be very, very mindful of that. And don't believe the hype. You know, telesales is not easier than field sales. Mm-mm. It's much more difficult.
We talked about that like two episodes ago.
Yeah, it's much more difficult.
What do you mean? Let's go into that.
Well, you need to be trained to know how to communicate without using most of the tools used to communicate. In other words, you have the nonverbal cues are not prevalent over the phone. So you need to be talking and communicating and even exaggerating some aspects of the way you're doing that to fully communicate the message that you're trying to your customer. When I'm sitting with Miss Mary and mm-hmm. I can touch Miss Mary's hand and be sentimental, it's so much easier to communicate certain, whatever I'm trying to communicate to her. Well, you can't do that over the phone. So you need to be prepared for it to be more difficult before it becomes easy. Now, I believe that it'll become much more easier than face-to-face, but it's going to be much more difficult at first.
Interesting. So
for everybody.
Okay. So what else? What other advice would you give someone?
So you need, whenever you go into business, you need to have some capital. I mean, you need to be prepared to not make any money for 3 months.
Okay.
So you need to have three months worth of bills saved up, ready to spend on all your bills, because it's going to be a 90-day learning curve. There's no doubt about that. And I would say the same for face-to-face sales as well. You need to be prepared. Now, if you can't afford that or you're not willing to risk that, you need to
stay away.
Yeah, get a part-time job, work in the evenings. Yep. I'm not a big fan of that, but if mm-hmm. you're serious about it, then you'll work whatever it takes to make that happen.
Okay, so what? Any other wisdom just for that person transitioning or wanting to transition?
Yeah, I would say get in it for the right reasons. If you're looking for shortcuts, there are no shortcuts.
Okay.
You know, I've heard people say that success is not, there's no key to success, it's a combination lock.
Okay.
So it takes time, it takes patience. You need to go in with no plan B. Like if you're thinking, well, I'm gonna dabble with this and then eventually if it doesn't work, I'll go back into field sales, it's just not gonna work. You need to be so over face-to-face sales that you're just all in on the telesales. If you're not there, you got plenty of time to keep doing what you're doing. I think it's still lucrative.
So do you think it's a guarantee that a good producer that goes from field sales to telesales will absolutely make far less money those first couple months on telesales?
I would count on that.
Yeah, because I know that's not the way that some of our people think.
No, there's people that are buying marketing from us and using our training and stuff, and they're at 8, 6, 8, 10, sometimes 11K a week, and they're like, I want to now do telesales. And we're like, why?
Yeah.
You know? But they almost think, well, I'm going to make more. You know, it's like...
Every one of the agents that I have... every one of the agents, I'm thinking of almost every one of the agents that we have on staff has been a failed face-to-face agent.
Mm.
Almost every single one of them. Specifically out of the independent model.
Is that because of like an agent that's just an absolute rock star in the field isn't going to listen or adapt to what works best for your call center?
Ask me that one more time.
Is it that like a really good agent?
Uh-huh.
You know, because what's funny is you just mentioned they failed in the field.
Yeah.
I think most really good agents,
mm-hmm.
like, I probably wouldn't adapt well, and you probably aren't looking for someone like me, hypothetically, you know, had success as a field agent, because we just think we can do it our own way and figure it out, and it's like it doesn't plug into the system that you have.
Well, I think if you're experiencing success in the field, you're probably not looking for me anyways.
Yeah.
Although there are some that think, if I can do this and do it well, I want to do it over the phone, but they're not looking for my setup. Like, this is truly a plug and play setup. We're doing everything for you. The independent model, which is preached in the industry, and I have my own opinions on that, is go out, start your own business, do it on your own, hustle hard, make a lot of money. I believe that's a farce. I don't think that's how it shakes out for most people. And the people that followed that dream
mm-hmm.
and end up seeing that it's really a nightmare are looking for more support, where they have the they can build a business, they can be their own boss, but still have the support financially, emotionally, to help with training, like all the support needed to actually do that. I think if you look at any business, that support needs to be there. You look at a franchise model compared to, you know, mom and pop opening up a restaurant. It's more difficult when you're doing it on your own.
Yeah.
And so just it, as business sense, partnering up with somebody helps compress time. Instead of learning everything, you got someone who's already going to just give it to you, and you just follow a very specific part of that process. So our niche really is the failed face-to-face agent who couldn't make it for whatever reason and is looking for a partner to help them with that.